You're probably like me, you've been watching the celebrities up the woods, Ant and Beck, what is it? I'm a Celebrity, get me out of here. So I've decided if those crazy madcap superstars can do those challenges, then I can do it too. So I'm going to set myself a couple of challenges here today, see how I get on. This is going to be fun. Yeah, so I've parachuted myself into this thick jungle here, and my first challenge is going to be this. So Ant and Dec are going to be floating little stars down the river there, and I'm going to be partially drowning myself in the river, and at the same time I'm going to eat a raw ferret's anus and collect as many stars as I can. Here goes. Oh, I did it! Yes! If you come on this programme, remember, the worst thing you can ever do is say, I'm a celebrity, get me out of here. Never say it. You'll bestow shame not only on yourself, but your whole family. Never say it. Time for the next challenge. Woo. I'm not really there. I'm here, in this cemetery. In fact, I am firmly grounded in reality, no reality TV. I came up here yesterday to visit one of my ancestors' graves. It just got me thinking, so I've came back up here with some flowers today. That's something that I've never done in my life, is brought flowers to a grave. But when I'm looking around here, you know, it becomes apparent that some graves, the new ones, are pristine and clean and covered in flowers and getting visitors every week or every month or whatever, you know. But then other ones, as they get older, they get forgotten about. They become dead stones, like the dead people underneath them. And with the most dignity and respect I can possibly muster up, the person who's buried under this grave here probably doesn't have a single person alive on this earth thinking about them or talking about them or remembering them. So what's the point I'm trying to make here? Well, I suppose it's this. If you're sitting in your house tonight watching I'm a Celebrity getting them out of here and watching God knows who getting cockroaches poured over them and thinking, is this all my life is about? Should I not be doing more with my life? Then the answer is probably no, because you're probably just going to end up as a dirty old stone at the back of some huge cemetery that nobody ever visits anyway. So watch it, enjoy it, and don't think too much about it. Dust in the wind. All they are is dust in the wind. Same old song. Just a drop of water in an endless sea. Time for my next challenge, and I'm really excited about this one, I can tell you. What I'm going to do is, I'm going to be stripped naked, smeared in various types of animal excrement, and I'm going to be suspended to that tree up there. Ant's going to be at the bottom, chucking bricks at my head, and Dick's going to be at the top, chucking these stars down, and I need to catch as many stars as I can. I really need to do this, I need to get a meal for all the other cultural icons back at the camp, so here goes. Wish me luck. Another thing I've been thinking a lot about this week is Armistice Day and Poppy Day. And you know, I come here to Cadden Foot Church in the Scottish Borders, and we have this dignified, modest monument to remember the people, the local people who died in the war. And you know, it's a tribute. I love the tribute where people can come and remember their ancestors. But it seems to me now, in Britain in general, it's becoming so commercialised, for want of a better word. These big pompous ceremonies in London and huge art installations, and what has that got to do with the war? It's almost becoming like a victory parade. Don't you like it? I like coming here and looking at the wee monuments like that. Now, all this talk about celebrities has got me thinking about another monumental day in history which happened this week. And no, I'm not talking about man landing a satellite probe on a comet. What I'm talking about is Kim Kardashian. If
you don't know who Kim Kardashian is, I didn't either, but I just googled it. Apparently she's some sort of American reality TV star, but anyway, she got her bum out and she's got a muckle big bum. Unbelievable. I mean, I'm going through, it's like grieving. I'm going through different stages. First I was in denial, I was thinking, nah, this can't have happened. And then I was angry, I was thinking, why has she done that? Why is she getting her big bum out? But then I started to accept it and I started to get a bit, you know, a bit sad. But now I'm starting to feel happy about it. I think it's really, really a good thing to have happened. But, I mean, the world has been in shock this week, it really has. But one thing I was thinking about is, if you've got a bigger bum, does that mean you need bigger pumps? Dickhead. Now all this talk about Kim Kardashian has got me thinking about the Black Death, bubonic plague. Now at the moment in Britain here we seem to be in a bit of a frenzy about this Ebola. How many people have actually died of Ebola in Britain? None, I don't think. Back in the medieval times, the Dark Ages, 3/4 of the population of Europe was wiped out by the Black Death. And you might think, that's in the past, it's history, it's gone, but here in Galashiels, this is the oldest cemetery in Galashiels, there are plague deaths at the plague graves at the back. How can you tell? Because they've all got the skull and crossbone on them. So here they are. The whole row here is all plague deaths. So if you're going to exhume a grave in Galashiels, don't do these, because you might kickstart the plague. Bob Geldof should be ashamed that his ancestors never done anything about the Black Death when they were alive. Nothing. If you've just wasted 5 minutes of your life and watched that video, you're probably thinking, what the hell was that about? Who was that aimed at? What's he trying to say? And the answer is, I don't know. I think I'm trying to just make a wee diary for myself and for my daughter maybe in years to come, when, you know, I'm dead and gone, my daughter can look back and think, you know, at least I've got a record of what my dad was like. I don't know if I really want her to remember me like that, but at least it's more than a tombstone, I suppose. Well, that's the end of today's video. Hope you've enjoyed it. Ta-ta. Say ta-ta. Ta-ta. Yay.